What do you think of when you hear the word turnbuckle? Okay, but what is it? What is it used for? Besides that, what is it used for in the world of rigging? By the end of this video, you'll understand what a turnbuckle is, how to use it, and how to select the correct type of turnbuckle for your application. My name is Ben, and this is the Lifting and Rigging Channel. Today, I'll be breaking down the differences between the different turnbuckle types and parts, and I'll show you how they work. I'll show you how they can help eliminate slack and adjust the tension of your rigging assembly. So, let's get into it. First, what is a turnbuckle? What is its purpose? A turnbuckle is a piece of hardware used to eliminate slack and adjust tension in a rope, cable, or other tensioning system. ASME B3026 rigging hardware defines a turnbuckle as an adjustable device consisting of three primary components: a body, a right-hand threaded end fitting, and a left-hand threaded end fitting. The end fitting on either side of a turnbuckle connects to the securement point or tensioning system. The turnbuckle is then tightened or loosened, eliminating slack in the cable or rope it is connected to. Let's look back at our wrestling example. When a wrestler throws their opponent into the ropes, they expect them to bounce back for some extra punishment. What allows for that slingshot effect? Tension. The ropes are pulled tight. And how do they get them to that perfect amount of tension that allows for both bodies to whip off the ropes and wrestlers to climb to the top? Turnbuckles. The rope is attached to a turnbuckle. The turnbuckle is tightened, eliminating slack in the ropes. There are several different types of turnbuckles. But before we get into those, let's talk about the turnbuckle parts. This is the body. The body joins two threaded end fittings. The body itself is turned to adjust tension, extending and retracting the end fittings. There are closed body turnbuckles and open body turnbuckles. Open bodies are the most common and allow you to see the threads through the frame. Closed bodies, or pipe bodies, enclose the threads and can be slimmer, fitting into tighter spaces. Some turnbuckles have a nut, also referred to a jam nut. The nut is used to tighten down on the body to help prevent the device from loosening or unthreading. Only use a jam nut in non-critical applications. In a critical application, the nut can put too much strain on the threads. For critical applications, it is better to use lock wire to prevent end fittings from turning, especially when exposed to vibrations that could loosen your turnbuckle. End fittings. These are the two connection points that screw into the opposite ends of the turnbuckle body. One end fitting is right-hand threaded, while the other is left-hand threaded, allowing you to turn the body to adjust the tension without moving the end fitting. There are three main types of end fittings, but more on that in a second. The total length of the end fitting that can screw in and out of the body to take up tension is called the take-up length. Take-up length is often measured in terms of open end fittings. The end fittings are fully extended, or closed end fittings. The end fittings are fully retracted. The thread diameter is the diameter measurement of the threaded portion of the end fittings. The greater the thread diameter is, the greater the load-bearing capacity of the turnbuckle. Before we move on, I want to point out the most important part of your turnbuckle: the identification. According to ASME B3026 rigging hardware, you must be able to read on each turnbuckle the name or trademark of the manufacturer, and the size or the rated load. The rated load will be marked as WLL, working load limit. Never let your load exceed that limit. If the identification is missing or no longer visible, do not use the turnbuckle. There are three main types of end fittings that can be used in any combination on either end of the turnbuckle. you have the hook end. This is best for temporary connections, as they are quick to connect and disconnect. Never use a hook end in an application where tension could unexpectedly release. This is called a jaw end. A jaw end fitting consists of a jaw and a bolt secured together by a nut or a pin. These are used to connect components that cannot be opened. For example, eye bolts. And this is an eye end. The eye end fitting is a closed loop that can be connected to a shackle or a quick link. Turnbuckle types are named for the combination of end fittings used in the device. The most common are jaw and jaw, eye and jaw, eye and eye, hook and eye, and hook and hook. Depending on what you'll be connecting to, are you connecting to components that cannot be opened, such as eye bolts? Or are you connecting to a connection point that can be open and closed, such as shackles or quick links? Whatever you will be connecting to will determine what type of turnbuckle you should use. Remember to consider both ends of the turnbuckle and both ends of your connection points before making a purchase. Also remember that it is better to use jaws and eyes for permanent or long-term assemblies. Hooks can be used for temporary assemblies or when connection points are frequently changed, but never use a hook if there is a chance that you might lose tension. If you are using a hook, then there is always a chance that it could unhook. The most common turnbuckle materials are galvanized and stainless steel. Stainless steel turnbuckles are ideal for use in outdoor and saltwater environments, as they are extremely resilient to rust and corrosion. If corrosion is a concern, stainless steel is likely the best choice for your turnbuckle material. Galvanized steel turnbuckles are cheaper than stainless steel and can also be used in outdoor applications. But keep in mind, they are not as resistant to corrosion as stainless steel turnbuckles. All right, so now that you should have an idea of what turnbuckle you will need, let's talk about how to install it. Step one. Unscrew your end fittings so you have open end fittings and are using full take-up length, like this. Step two, connect both ends of your end fittings to your securement points. If you're using an eye end fitting, simply loop it through whatever securement point it'll be connected to. If you're using a shackle like this, loop it through and screw in the pin. For a hook end fitting, just hook it to whatever point it'll be temporarily secured to. For a jaw end fitting, unscrew the nut or remove the cotter pin. Remove the bolt or the pin and place the securement point between the clevis ears. Put the bolt back and tighten the nut. Step three, turn the body of the turnbuckle to tighten it and take up your tension. Once you have it hand tight, you should use a properly sized wrench used on the wrench flats of the turnbuckle body to adjust the desired tension. The cool thing about a turnbuckle is the tension can be applied without twisting or rotating your rope or cable. Last step, if you're using a jam nut, tighten the nut down to the body. If your turnbuckle is being used for a critical application, use lock wire to prevent end fittings from turning. A turnbuckle may be used on its own or in conjunction with other turnbuckles to increase length in the assembly. And as a constant reminder, keep your working load limit in mind when installing your turnbuckles and do not exceed it. Don't use your turnbuckle if any damage appears to be present. Check the link below to find out how turnbuckles are inspected and what rejection criteria you should be looking for. All right, great. So now that you know which turnbuckle you should be using and how to install them, let's talk about when you might want to use a turnbuckle. We already mentioned this. Turnbuckles are used in the world of sports and entertainment to tighten the ropes surrounding boxing and wrestling rings. Turnbuckles are also common on ships, used to tension a ship's lashing and rigging components. They're often seen in wire and cable fencing to pull them tight. In aviation, cables and wires present within the construction of an aircraft, wings, flight control systems, etc., are tensioned by turnbuckles. And turnbuckles are often used to provide tension support in the construction of suspension bridges, large buildings, and highway guardrail cable assemblies. You may even see turnbuckles used in tension cables supporting trees, telephone poles, and signs. Turnbuckles are also used in the world of fall protection. When constructing a building, cable guardrails are used as a form of passive fall protection tensioned with turnbuckles. And turnbuckles are used to tension cable on lifeline systems for fall restraint and fall arrest as well. So remember, when choosing a turnbuckle, remember to pay attention to what you are connecting to and what connection components are on either end of the turnbuckle. Choose your end fittings accordingly. Decide if this is a long-term or a temporary assembly, and if there is a concern that your assembly may at any point lose tension. Consider the environment when choosing what materials, and always keep your working load limit in mind. One last bit of advice. If you're using a quarter-inch cable or eye bolt, the fittings on a quarter-inch turnbuckle will most likely be too small, and the quarter-inch turnbuckle will have a lower working load limit. Always rely on the working load limit when selecting your turnbuckle. Choose a turnbuckle that matches or exceeds the working load limit of the assembly. And before you use a hook end fitting, check that the hook will fit through your connecting components. If you need more information or you're looking for more lifting and rigging training, you can click the link below to contact a Mozilla lifting and rigging specialist. There you can also find a full inventory of turnbuckles and other rigging hardware from leading manufacturers, so you can find the best solution for your needs. So, I hope after watching this video, you now understand what turnbuckles are, how they function, and whether they can be applied to your rigging assemblies. If you found this video useful, informative, entertaining, or you just feel like being friendly, then hit that like button so we can get this information out to everyone who needs it. Subscribe and hit the bell so you never miss a video. If you have a question, drop it in the comments so we can get you an answer. My name is Ben, and I'll see you in the next one.